We are YSTV and we're here at Summer Ball 2024!
Hello, my name is Jordan. I'm reporting for YSTV and I am joined by...
Mia, she, her.
Will, he, him.
Matty, he, him.
Jack, he, him.
And do you want to tell us the name of your band as well?
We're called Catch! Exclamation mark.
Is the exclamation mark important?
You have to be grammatically correct with these things.
Of course. So my first question for you, my most important question is, are you excited to play tonight?
Very excited, yes. How do you feel, mate?
Yeah, I'm really excited. I haven't been to Summer Bowl before and I'm in second year, so I'm excited to play it, yeah.
So to clarify, you've not been to the ball before and your first time in the ball, you're like playing it.
Yeah, that's just the way we do things around.
Oh yeah, of course. Right, so I heard a little birdie told me, a little brown birdie told me that one of your singles came out last week. Was it last week? Yeah. Do you want to talk a bit about that?
Yeah, so we released our debut single last week.
Yeah, I went to the zoo one day and I came back and I listened to some Block Party.
Yep.
I was listening to Helicopter by Block Party. That is the inspiration for the riff behind the start of a bad joke.
Yeah, which came out last week.
Was it last week?
Yeah, it's only been a week. It's not been that long. Came out last week. It's been a lot of fun. Like, we've been at gigs since and like having people sing the it's been good. It was a bit of a process though.
Singing produced, the riff at gigs, yeah. It's great.
Produced by JW Blake. Mm-hmm. A fucking legend of a man who just
came from
saw him play
him.
Like
amazing
about 15
set,
minutes
by
ago
the way.
Cracking set.
Amazing.
Debut single, hopefully more to come after that. It was really a really fun process, just like going in the studio for like a full day with a couple cans and some food, and it was so much fun. But yeah, it got released and people like it, so that's good.
Okay, my question to you then is, you talked about just like going to the studio one day and then like recording this fantastic song that's made you famous. What, like, did you come into it knowing what you were going to write about? Like, you mentioned the zoo as well. Like, are you the writer of the group? Is that what's happening here?
I write the riffs and the chords, but all of the lyrics is Mia, and then all of the bass is Matty, drums is Jack, obviously. Our last song we recorded, Chalk and Cheese, we hadn't written until the morning of the day we were meant to record it.
Right.
So we finished writing it that morning, which was quite...
But Start of a Bad Joke was different.
That was... Yeah, that was prepared. Completed for a long time.
Said everything.
okay, sure. So this idea of like going to the studio, recording it all in one day, is that like the usual process for you guys or is there more to it?
Do you want me to speak? Okay, yeah, no, so we have, do I announce it or not? We have an EP coming out soon.
You have an EP coming out soon?
Coming out soon.
Oh my God, no way.
There's no
What's
day.
It called? Do
it's
you know?
It's called the Frequency of Thought and it's coming out soon. We don't have a date for it yet. Very soon. Watch this space. It's coming out.
Yeah.
But we talked to JW Blake and we were like, look, we want to put out an EP. We're going to get it done by this date. And he was like, say less. So we went to the studio, recorded it. But it was like, the process for each song was really different. Like the first two we had like nailed, I feel. And then we went for the last two, which we would finish the night before.
Right.
They were a struggle, weren't they? But it was so much fun. Like, just getting to go and spend like a whole evening in this like really cool studio in the physics department. Like, it was so cool. Big up physics. Will studies physics, so big up physics.
Oh, ew. Yeah. Why do you study physics?
But like, Matty would be like, I mean, you could talk about it, but you would be in and out. You'd be like...
Yeah, so everyone else was just... messing on with doing that. No, I just used to just take like 10 minutes and sorry and everyone else was in there for like an hour and a half, and I'd be in and out 10 minutes and then just be there like 6 hours just chilling with James. So, but no, it was all really good fun, and it was all like sort of role playing a proper band and things like that. It was really, yeah.
Role playing is a crazy way to phrase that. And the reason I say that is because I know that you guys have done shows. Like, I have friends who've talked about going to see your shows. And more importantly, you're going to be touring this summer. So role playing is like a crazy way to describe that.
We're still role playing it. It's still keeping it going.
Of course, So speaking of touring this summer, I know I brought it up, but I'm going to segue from my own statement to another question. What is it like, what are you most excited about for this summer? Because this is a big summer for you, right? This is the first time you've toured, no?
New places, yeah. I mean, I'm from the northeast, Marty's from the northeast. We're playing a gig in Newcastle, so that's a big thing for us. But I've been to Cambridge before, but can't wait to go see Cambridge properly this time as well. Yeah.
Whoa, that's too much. I live in Cambridge, and we're doing a gig in Cambridge on the 19th, which is very exciting.
June.
Of June, yeah, sorry, June. Of this June, of this June, of this month. I'm really excited for that, to play in front of all my, my home friends and stuff. That'd be really great.
Can I have the microphone back?
Yes.
Yeah, thank you. God. Talent keeps trying to steal my mic. This is my whole thing. Whereabouts in Cambridge are you playing? Are you playing the Junction? Are you playing the Corn Exchange?
Not quite.
Wish I was playing the Junction. It's a very big venue. Out of our league. We're playing the Portland Arms. Which is very exciting because I saw the Sherlocks there a few years back. And to be playing the same stage as them. I mean, not at the same time.
We're there supporting Milkman Jack, which is Tom Sheldon's band. Tom Sheldon Trio are also playing tonight. They're playing just after us, actually. Mm. It's really exciting. Tom basically, like, it was a very odd way of getting a gig. Tom put something on his story and was like, anyone in any Cambridge-based bands free for this gig? We're like basically a Cambridge-based band. So we replied and... Yeah, so Cambridge, Newcastle, and who knows what's next?
The world, right? The world is what is next.
Catch takes over the world.
Okay, this is exciting. And now my follow-up question. Do you have like a set list for when you're touring this summer? And for tonight, do you know what you're playing tonight? I hope the answer to that is yes, we know what we're playing tonight, but...
We do know what we're playing tonight. We'll be playing... We're on in, like, what, 2 hours? We've been here since, like, 3 o'clock, and it is, like, 9 o'clock? Hours. We've already done everything that you can do at Summer Ball. But we are...
Not a lot to do.
There's loads to do. We went on all the rides. Anyway, tonight we'll be playing 3 of our original songs from the EP, and then a really exciting cover twice of your favourite... cartoon dog show
by Simple Plan. Scooby-Doo.
What's New Scooby-Doo? We'll be playing twice.
That is a fantastic song. I love that song.
Well, basically I'm gonna flex a bit. We headlined the Fulford Arms a couple of weeks ago, it was like our first big headline gig, and one of the things that we did was we played What's New Scooby-Doo twice, and it went down really well. There were mosh pits. We had our first stage invader. Big shout out to Ava Ubertalski. She's Ava got pushed over in a mosh pit and ended up on stage. Her drink was all over my shoes. Bless her. But it went down really well. So, but we've had multiple requests since being like, "Where's Scooby-Doo in your set list?" So. As the most professional band in Bandsock, we will be playing What's New Scooby-Doo tonight.
Yeah, that's the set list for tonight. We normally play all... The first song we wrote was Pillowcase, written by Mia. We're not playing it, yeah. We have The Start of a Bad Joke, which is obviously the single. And then we have Get a Grip, and Chalk and Cheese are the other two, and those four make up the EP. And we normally play all four of them, but as it's a 20-minute set tonight, I don't think we'll have time to play all four. If we really want to fit in Scooby-Doo,
yeah,
that is.
Yeah, no, fair enough. I think you have taken perhaps the most unique approach to picking a cover that we've had with the bands that we've interviewed today. There's been some that feel like, oh, this is just songs that we really love and we want to share them with people. And there's some that's like, oh, everyone loves this song, so we're going to do this. You're the first band to pick a song that has been requested by like their fans, which is very exciting for you, right?
It's not even like getting requested. It's people turning up at our gigs and be like, where was Scooby-Doo? Why didn't you play Scooby-Doo? So, we're a band of the people. So we're giving the people what they want and playing a silly little song about a dog. Do you know what I mean?
It's a great song, so it makes sense. I do have a serious question now, if you want to answer. So, how would you describe your sound? This is the question I ask everybody.
Please say the quote. Go on.
Well, if you wear earmuffs and a blindfold, it's Paramore? Yeah, it's Paramore. If not, it's Catch. Yeah. And we're our own sound, but yeah.
I think we take a lot of inspiration from, like, the music-wise, a lot of inspiration from, like, Block Party, Wolf Alice. But yeah, the kind of like meme of the band is, if you wear earmuffs and a blindfold, it's Paramore. Yeah, I don't know how else we'd describe it, to be honest. It's just, I don't know. I think we have our own.
That's well put.
Yeah, well put. I think we have our own kind of sound within that kind of, within the like indie rock genre.
Indie rock.
Yeah, I'd say so, yeah.
Okay. And like, do you all listen to Paramore? Like, what sort of music, like, who are your favourite artists? Tell me that.
That is a loaded question. I listen to a lot of, oh God, you've put me on the spot now.
We all love the Strokes.
We all listen to Strokes. We do listen to Wolf Alice, Catfish. Sorry, Matty. Matty doesn't like Catfish.
Why don't you like Catfish?
It's a long story. I don't think you have enough tip.
But it's all kind of in that genre. Like, if you want to give your own ideas, Wonder Horse, like lots of fun things.
Wonder Horse is a
good inspiration.
I've been in some really weird things that are the exact opposite of Catch recently, like Australian post-punk and things like that. So yeah, it's not always like Wolf Alice and Paramore. It can be weird, stupid things.
You keep stealing my mic. We're gonna scrap in a minute. I'm gonna fight the lead singer of Catch live on YSTV. Fight Night Part 2. Yeah.
Probably the fire alarms
would
go off in that one.
Oh yeah, true. Yeah, I might pull it just to get out of it. I feel like you might beat me. Sorry, I got fully distracted by my own joke. So what was I asking you? I was asking you about Paramore and about your sound. Do you feel like you have done like the thing for you guys? Do you feel like you've made music that encapsulates who you are, or do you feel like there's more to it? Do you feel like you've got room to grow and room to like push and find new artists and be new people, I guess?
I mean you wrote it, but this EP is very much themed about relationships, as is stereotypical of songs, and university life.
I think the EP currently really encapsulates where Catch is at the moment. Yeah. It's very much like, oh, you're a student, and these are the silly things that you do as a student, and these are the only times that you get to do these stupid things and excuse them because you're a student. So I think for the past year at least, the EP really encapsulates where we are, but I think we definitely have room to grow. No promises, but we definitely have some ideas up the sleeves, don't we? Don't we, everyone?
Do you have anything you can share with us?
Nothing yet. No, I don't know how much I can say. No. We've got some bilingual songs in the mix. I won't say any more than that.
Wow, okay, okay. Interesting. You mentioned the Australian post-punk as well. But I think, like, those two things, the, like, journeying into new music, approaching the way that you write songs in perhaps an inventive way, even if that involves time pressure and some alcohol. I think that's really the marker of a good band. And, like, you guys talk about being a university band. I think that Mia is in third year, am I right?
Yes.
And I think the thing that we've been discussing quite a lot today with our bands is this idea of, like, what happens next. So what I want to know now is, like, where do you go from here? Especially if you're graduating, how do you stay a band?
Yeah, I mean...
My dude, that is a loaded question.
Yeah, I mean...
It kind
we
of...
We always...
The thing is...
said that we... we wish that we met in first year. But I think if we were in first year, then all of this wouldn't have happened.
Yeah.
It was this sense of urgency that...
I think
made all this happen.
The beauty of Catch is, I'm third year, Will's first year, and these two are second year. So we're all kind of at very, very different points in our uni experience, which, I'm not going to lie, I kind of forced on these guys to kind of move a bit quicker because I knew that I was going to graduate. In terms of what's next, we were literally talking about it about an hour ago because it's a topic of conversation for us. I don't know, I'm kind of toying with the idea of staying on another year, but no matter what the outcome is, even if I leave, I don't think it's going to be the end of Catch. I think that we will... Yeah, no matter, he's shaking his head.
Yeah, we'll make it happen.
Yeah, we'll make it happen. Like, whatever... Wherever we are, I think Catch will still be a thing. I love these guys so much, and they've made my third year, like, so much more fun than it would have been if I hadn't done a band. So, like... I'm not really ready to let go of them yet.
That's really sweet. I didn't mean to set you up to make me cry, but... Okay, yeah, I understand that. I think you guys have room to grow, and I'm excited to see where that takes you. I think that might be the end of our interview, guys, you know? And I kind of don't want to let you go. I feel like I've got so much more to find out about you. But I hope the set goes well. And I look forward to hearing you tour across the country. I'm going to be in my 50s saying, you know, I interviewed Catch once. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Oh, yes. Oh, my God, you're so correct. So,
I know how these things work.
If you had to, just put you on the spot, like, do you have anything coming out soon? Anything we should know?
So we have our single called The Start of a Bad Joke, which... like we said, came out last week, which can be streamed everywhere, Apple Music, Spotify, whatever you use. We are catchband_ on Instagram. We are catchband_ on TikTok. And I don't know how else to say it, but watch this space. There's more exciting things coming.